six. Number six, was there another creation before God created the universe? Genesis 1, verse 2, the Spirit hovering over the water. Turn over there with me to Genesis chapter 1. Genesis chapter 1, verse 1 says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was formless and void, and the darkness was over the surface of the deep, and the Spirit of God was moving over the surface of the waters. If I understand this question correctly, then the person is asking, when it says the Spirit was hovering over the waters, does that mean some waters of another universe or another world before he separates the waters on earth? I think that's what the questioner is asking. My understanding, if I understand the question correctly, the answer is this. We have no information indicating that there was another creation before God created the universe. According to the Word of God, there is a record of only one universe, only one creation of one universe. Is it possible that God has done that and not recorded it for us in Scripture? It's possible, but there is no reason to think that. No reason whatsoever. No reason biblically, and no reason scientifically. And the reason they pose it scientifically is to escape the realities of the math that points to a divine creator and the impossibility of our universe existence. So let's look here. If you go down to verse 7 of Genesis chapter 1, it says, God made the expanse and separated the waters which were below the expanse from the waters which were above the expanse, and it was so. God called the expanse heaven, and there was evening and there was morning the second day. Then God said, let the waters below the heavens be gathered into one place, and let the dry land appear. And it was so. So what we seem to have is, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, and the earth is, it says it's formless and void, which means there's just no separation between anything. And sometimes they'll talk about another planet that is a gaseous ball or something like that. Earth was apparently that way, where there wasn't any real distinction between liquid water and water vapor or gas form, water and gas form. And there was no land sticking up above the water. And so God separated that. But in verse 2, where it says the Spirit of God hovered above the waters, it's evident that the world, that the earth, is covered in water when he first creates it. When he creates the heavens and the earth, that includes land and water, and later he separates the water vapor from the liquid water, and then he separates the oceans from the land and brings the land upward and gathers the waters, the liquid waters, into the ocean. But there's nothing there, nothing anywhere in there that would indicate that the waters over which the Spirit of God was hovering existed before chapter 1, verse 1, before the previous verse, when God created the heavens and the earth. Verse 2, the Spirit of God hovered over the face of the waters or over the face of the deep. Just indicates that face of the deep is what was created in verse 1, God created the heavens